I mean, what the heck? Python, what the hell is this? This just looks weird, doesn't it? But what if I told you that actually that's not Python's fault? This wrong result happened because of the little chip inside your PC. This little asshole is too stupid to perform some basic addition with floating point numbers. If you try the same trick in any other language, you will get the exact same result. The problem is that our computers use point floating math, because our memory is limited and we have to have a trade-off between precision and range. So let's analyze why it happens. Let's suppose that we have a simple floating point number, for example 0.3. As you know, CPUs use the binary system, but we people actually use the decimal one. So in order to store this number in the memory, we have to convert it into the binary system. If you paid enough attention to university courses, which I doubt, then you should know how to do it. So we're taking the fractional part, multiplying it by 2, and here we have the last digit of the number in the binary system, and then the remainder should be multiplied by 2 until it becomes 0. But here we have a problem. The remainder will never be equal to 0 because, as you can see, we came right to the point where we started. So if we continue this process, it will never end. As I said in the beginning, the memory in our PC is limited, so we can't do this until infinity. The precision of a float point number is 16, so let's do this process 16 times and then store it in the memory. So it seems like we're good. Now it's time to print the number out, and in order to do that, the CPU has to convert it back to a decimal number, so we developers could understand it. So let's try to do it manually. We have this number in binary, and we have to convert it to a decimal one. So we're taking the current digit, raising it to the power of its position, and continue doing it for each digit. Let's finish the calculations, and what do we see? The number is not the number that we stored initially. Okay, Turing, our CPUs are broken, let's start from scratch. No, you silly. This error is not that big and it happens only for numbers whose fractional parts tend to infinity. For example, 1 divided by 3. So our computers are actually smart as hell, but the thing is that they have certain constraints, so that's why your computer can't do division properly. Hit the like and the subscribe button if you want to see more videos like this. Thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next one.